Assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Wa alaykum assalam.
Inna alhamdulillahi nahmaduhu wa nasta'inuhu wa nastaghfiruh. Wa na'udhu billahi min shururi anfusina wa sayyiati a'malina. Man yahdihillahu fala mudilla lah wa man yudlil fala hadiya lah. Wa ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wahdahu la sharika lah. وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وسلم وعلى آله وأصحابه وأزواجه ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين سبحانك لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا إنك أنت العليم الحكيم اللهم اجعلنا ممن يستمعون القول فيتبعون أحسنه اللهم اجعلنا مخلصين لك الدين اللهم علمنا ما ينفعنا وانفعنا بما علمتنا وتوفنا مسلمين صالحين تائبين مغفورا لنا يا رب العالمين وأدخلنا برحمتك الفردوس الأعلى من الجنة بغير حساب ولا عذاب ولا عقاب ونجنا من عذاب القبر وعذاب الحشر وعذاب النار برحمتك يا الله يا غفار أما بعد today is Saturday and today's date is the كم الهجرة يا إخوانا اليوم 12 the 12th هجرة 12 the 12th it is the 12th of the 12th of المحرم for the year 1435 of the هجرة of the migration of our great beloved Prophet Muhammad رسول الله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم which coincides with the 16th of November for the year 2013. Before we start the class of Tafsir, I have two observations, so please pay attention. First, in As-Salaah, we have to make sure that every haraka, every move of the Salaah, ruku' or sujood or qiyam, or anything in between is very distinguished. And the second thing, every dhikr in As-Salaah is very distinguished. What does it mean? As-Salaah cannot be just a circle you are going without distinguishing it. Example, we say Allahu Akbar, then we move to Ar-Ruku'. When we are totally in a ruku', the hands, if possible, because Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم commanded the least for the ruku' to be considered ruku', he said to the al-musi' salatahu, the person who prayed wrongfully, he said, make sure that the palms of your hands are what? Are firmed on where? On your knees. So once I am in ruku', now I distinguish between the move and between the ruku', they are separated from one another. Going to the ruku', I said Allahu Akbar, then I am in ruku'. Once I am in ruku', now I say what? Subhana Rabbi al-Azim, Subhana Rabbi al-Azim, Subhana Rabbi al-Azim. And the dua itself is distinguished. It's not Subhana Rabbi al-Azim, Subhana Rabbi al-Azim, Subhana Rabbi al-Azim. Yeah? It is Subhana Rabbi al-Azim, Subhana Rabbi al-Azim, Subhana Rabbi al-Azim. Same thing. When we say سَمَعَ اللَّهُ لِمَنْ حَمِدَهُ some people, they say it and I hear it behind me, it is سَمَعَ اللَّهُ مَنْ حَمِدَ رَبَّنَا وَلَكَ الْحَمْدُ. That's very wrong. Absolutely wrong. So while you are rising, you say, while you are rising, سَمَعَ اللَّهُ لِمَنْ حَمِدَهُ. And Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم said what? فَإِذَا اعْتَدَلْتَ. And once you are what? Straight, up straight. Now what do you say? رَبَّنَا وَلَكَ الْحَمْدِ. You do not raise your hands when you are saying رَبَّنَا وَلَكَ الْحَمْدِ. Raising the hands, as we read in Sahih al-Bukhari and Sahih Muslim, it is while you are saying what? سَمِعَ اللَّهُ لِمَنْ حَمِدَ. Now, put my hands down. Now I am in full standing, upright. Now where I say what? رَبَّنَا لَكَ الْحَمْدِ or رَبَّنَا وَلَكَ الْحَمْدِ or the dua that is in the sunnah of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم. So please be careful. This continuous salah, it is not salah. Yeah? That's why Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told al-Sahabi al-Jaleel, ارجع فصلي فإنك إيش؟ لم تصل. Go back and pray, for you have not prayed. Second thing, it is minor, but it's very good. Two notes. Please be careful. To get the reward of the tasbih, which is a huge reward. Let me share with you the hadith of Abu Dharr radiyallahu anhu. There are many hadiths, but the most wonderful, the most rewarding is the hadith of Abu Dharr, where Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, anyone after the salah, anyone who says after the salah, عقب الصلاة. عقب الصلاة, that means immediately. عقب, it is not after 5 minutes, it's not after 2 minutes. من قال عقب الصلاة 33 times, subhanallah. 33 times, alhamdulillah. 33 times, Allahu Akbar. And to complete the 100, to say what? لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له له الملك وله الحمد وهو على كل شيء قدير غفر له ما تقدم من ذنبه ولو كان كزبد البحر. Huge reward should not be taken what? Lightly. He said, if you say that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive you your sins, even if it is as many as the foam on the surface of what? Of the sea. Huge foams. Every wave create what? Moves the air gets inside the water, you create what? A foam. The second part, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he addressed the ladies, the companion ladies of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, radiyallahu anhunna, qala wa aqadahunna, I cannot talk now in the feminine. Anyway, let me use the feminine. Wa aqadnahunna على الأنامل. سيد رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم said what? When you are counting them, when you're like, سبحان الله, use what? Use your what? Fingertips. سبحان الله, سبحان الله, سبحان الله, سبحان الله, سبحان الله, سبحان الله. Now the other thing that I noticed, some people, they use also their left hand. Their left hand should not be used for that for two reasons. First, the hadith says that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to spare his left hand for his dislikes. For his what? Dislikes. Like when you go to the bathroom, when you blow, clean your nose. And so on. And وَكَانَ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَعَلَى عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ يَعْقِدَهَا عَلَى يَمِينِهِ. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam himself, when he used to do it, he used to do it only in his what? Right hand. وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم. جزاكم الله خير. Now we can go back. تفضل حبيبي. Oh, let me just mention one thing. جزاك الله خير. ذكرتني. الله يبارك فيك. وجاك علينا خير. And some people, they do something very wrong. What do they do? After they finish صلاة الفرض, the obligatory صلاة, they go and pray Salat al-Sunnah, then they do the Tasbih. This is absolutely wrong. It is not the Sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Na'am. You have to do it what? عقب الصلاة. When you finish the Salah, because this is the Adhkar after the obligatory Salah. Not you go and pray Salat al-Sunnah or whatever Salah, then what? You do it. Jazakallah khair. Fadal abu. Okay. That's very good. This is washukur ya akhwa. It is not anywhere to be found in the Sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And we mentioned to you also linguistically, ناحية لغوية القح غير صحيحة. غير صحيحة على الإطلاق. So please, خير الهدي هدي محمد رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. تتأسس so many دعاءات. ربنا لك الحمد ربنا لك الحمد اللهم ربنا ولك الحمد ربنا لك الحمد حمدا كثيرا طيبا مباركا فيه مباركا عليه كما تحب وترضى ربنا لك الحمد من السماوات ومن الأرض ومن ما بينهما ومن ما شئت من شيء بعد. So many. So please, This is your salah. You have to do it what? Very right to the best of your ability. Jazakallah khair abu. Ramakum Allah. Yes, Hayyu.
I thought that to complete the 100, we have to say, 34 times Allahu Akbar.
Okay, that's why I said, let me mention the most rewarding among them, the hadith of Abu Dharr. We have, I think, three ways that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam taught us. That's why I said, being precise, let me mention the way that is reported in the hadith of Abu Dharr, because it is what the most rewarding, which is only in this text. You will find that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, if you say it, Allah will forgive you your sins, even if they are as much as the foam that is on the surface of the sea. Get happy? So you have three ways. Like when we say Rabbana lak alhamd, Rabbana wa lak alhamd, and so on and so forth. Got it, Habib? Yes, Ya Habib.
Sheikh, what age should we start in emphasizing kids to pray? And is it just a prayer or the whole, whole package?
Emphasizing Habib from day one. Okay, because the stages, there is no stages. Okay, because believe it or not, morality for the children starting learning morality, even this is the modern science. This is approved American science. They start comprehending the morality at the age of two. The morality, which is they call it rules. To get to school, is it right to do this? Is it wrong to do that? Is it good to hit people? Is it bad to hit people? And so on. So by emulation, all the time, sit them next to you, teach them this, teach them that, bring them to al-masjid. This is, does not. Now, when they move into the learning process, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did not leave it open. We know the hadith, the famous hadith that Muslims, they know it left and right. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam qala ish, muru awladakum bis salati lasam. Wal hadith al-akhir ish qad, allimuhum as-salata lisab. He said, command your children to pray at the age of seven. At the age of seven, that means, كما قال شيخنا الشيخ عبد العزيز بن باز رحمه الله عليه, قال أتموا السابعة ودخلوا في الإيش؟ في الثامنة. At the age of seven, that means they completed seven and now they are what? Into the what? Into the eighth. At this age, Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم said what? Teach them the prayer and command them to pray. So you start emphasizing it, if this is what you meant, at this age. Now, you start enforcing it. I hope that you understand my gibberish English. You start emphasizing it, commanding it, teaching it, at the age of what? Seven. When they are developed into where? Into the eighth. Not seven, they finished the sixth. Now they are in the seventh. They are not seven, by any account. Okay? So when they complete seven, all of the laws of the Sharia now are emphasized, taught, and what? And commanded. Now, this is at the age of seven. When do you enforce it? That means obligatory in you to enforce it. Allah will hold you responsible as a parent if you do not. When they reach the age of 10, that means they completed 10 and they are now in the age of what? Developed into where? Into the 12th, into the 11th. So here when Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said what? وَضْرِبُوهُمْ عَلَيْهَا لِعَشْرٍ وَضْرِبُوهُمْ عَلَيْهَا لِعَشْرٍ. And he said what? And discipline them, spank them, not beat them to hell. Spank them when they are at the age of what? At the age of 10. At the age of 10, he or she, they have to understand now they are old enough to observe the law of Allah al-Kareem subhanahu wa ta'ala. Got it?
So, Sheikh, at the age of 7, they should learn the whole thing, making wudu, and the dress should be proper, everything.
Everything. That's why the hadith came with what? Command them, and what? Allimuhum. Command them, teach them. Command them, teach them. Both. But you have to be as lenient as what? as possible. Because at the age of learning, you have to be extremely lenient. Get it, habibi? How do you know? Because Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said what? You do not become, you are not to be lenient at the age of what? 10. Get it, habibi? Sure? Yeah? So be as lenient as possible and these things. Any question? Yes?
What about the movements of the lip while praying?
Okay. Is the movement of the mouth, the lip, the lips, the tongue a must? Yes. يقول شيخ الإسلام ابن تيمية قال والتفكير بالفاتحة ليس قراءة ومن اعتقد أنها قراءة فقد كفر. Amazing. What is that? He said that is it necessary to move the mouth when you are reciting, or you can just thinking al-Fatiha, thinking the Quran? No, you have to recite, and reciting it has to be what? The movement of the mouth. That's why Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you read everywhere. How did you know that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was reciting? He said by the what? The movement of his beard. كان أحيانا صلى الله عليه وسلم يسمعنا القراءة. And sometimes that Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم used to what? Make us hear his recitation. Okay? And the quote that I quote from Ibn Taymiyyah said what? Thinking the Fatiha, thinking saying Subhanallah, Allahu Akbar, said thinking is not recitation. Anyone who believes after knowing what is the teaching of Islam, that thinking al-Fatiha or thinking Subhanallah, Subhan Rabbi al-Azim is a recitation, he is a kafir. You have to worship. That's why I told you one time, we were visited by a Catholic nun, and she said something which I learned from her, amazing. She said, I am so impressed and I admire your way of worship greatly. And when she asked why, she said, because you worship with all of your body. You worship with all of your body. Clear, Yahuwah? So moving the lips and the tongue, reading is must. No ifs, ands, or buts about it. Yes, Halim.
So behind the Shaykh, you know, when we're in the Dua, you know, for the Fatiha, you know, are we supposed to just keep quiet, you know, and let...
Okay. Then inshallah we are not going to have tafsir class, so please forgive me. So I'm not going to hold you more than that. He says, Abu Nurullah says, when the Imam is reciting loudly, the Ma'moom, the follower, should read, must read, obligatory to read, or to keep quiet. I'm sure that depends on the school of thought that you came from. You hear the following two opinions. Okay? We have actually three opinions. In the school of Abu Hanifa rahmatullahi alayhi, there is an opinion which is attributed also to Abu Hanifa rahmatullahi alayhi. Regardless if you hear or you do not hear, you do not read. Nothing. Whether it's loud or not loud, you hear the recitation, you do not hear the recitation, regardless if it's Maghrib, Isha, Jum'ah, Dhuhr, Asr, you do not read. You just stay quiet behind the Imam. And this is, we are not going to discuss it because this is very obvious against the Sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Okay? Now, in regard to Al-Fatiha. First, let me tell you why this question is raised. Because Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam said the following two statements and very authentic ahadith. La salata liman yaqra bil fatiha. La salata liman lam yaqra bi fatiha al kitab. There is no salah for the one who does not recite the fatiha of the book. which is Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. All of you know what's Al-Fatiha. Anybody doesn't know what's Al-Fatiha? Okay, which is Surah Al-Hamd. Okay, the other hadith, he said what? فَهِيَ خِدَاجٌ فَهِيَ خِدَاجٌ فَهُوَ خِدَاجٌ. Anyone who does not recite Surah Al-Fatiha, then his salah is incomplete, is incomplete, is incomplete. خِدَاج, literally it means what? The person who is born incomplete. Huh? Like فلان خِدَاج, he was born what? Incomplete. Therefore, some of the ulama, they said, at all times, regardless if you recite, if you hear the recitation of the imam, the salah is audible or unaudible, you have at all times to recite Al-Fatiha. Clear? Clear? And this is madhab Shaykhana Shaykh Abdul Aziz, Shaykh Ibn Athameen, وغيرهم من المعاصرين. Okay? The other opinion says no. Only when the salah is quiet, quiet salah, not silent. There is no silent salah. Silent, you are not saying anything. Okay? There is no such thing called silent salah. Yeah? When you are quiet, the quiet salah, the salah that unloud, yeah? Example, salat al-dhuhr, salat al-asr. Yeah? The last rak'ah of al-maghrib, the last two rak'ah of what? Of salat al-isha. These are, we recite what? Quietly. Yeah? Not loud. We move our mouth, we move our lips, we move our tongue, and we recite. Okay? So, the other would be saying what? If you can hear the imam, and you can hear the imam in Salat al-Maghrib, to first two rak'ahs, Salat al-Isha, first two rak'ahs, Salat al-Jum'ah, Salat al-Fajr, and so on, then you just listen and listen quietly. Okay? So these are the three schools of thought and many books authored in this subject. In defense of the first opinion, Imam al-Bukhari rahmatullahi alayhi authored what? Juzu, a whole book called Al-Qira'a Khalf al-Imam. Yeah? If you examine the Sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the practice of most of As-Sahaba al-Kiram, most, not all, you're going to find out that the sunnah is you recite only when the salah is what? Quiet. Okay? If you hear the recitation of the imam, you must stay quiet to hear it. To the point that Imam Ahmad rahmatullahi alayhi yaqul, the verse, that which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in it, وَإِذَا قُرَأَ الْقُرْآنُ فَاسْتَمِعُوا لَهُ وَأَنصِتُوا يَقُولْ هَذِهِ نَزَلَتْ خَاصَّةٌ فِي الصَّلَاةِ. Yeah? When the Quran is recited, then you listen to it attentively, so you may receive the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَيَقُولْ شَيْخ الْإِسْلَامِ بْنِ تَيْمِيَةَ فِي رِسَالَتِهِ أَيْضًا لَهُ كِتَابٌ جُزْءٌ اسْمُهُ إيش؟ الْقِرَاءَةُ خَلْفَ الْإِمَامِ. الإمام بحكم القراءة خلف الإمام. I said all the mufassirun, all the ulama of tafsir on the opinion that this verse was revealed in regard of what? Of the salah. When you hear the imam reciting, then you must what? Listen, you do not read. And of course, we have the practice of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the statement of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. From the practice of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, we know that the Sahaba al-Kiram, he commanded them to listen. Okay? So, if the Salah is loud and you can hear it, you are not deaf, you are not very far away, you have what? You have to listen. Now, it is a little bit taking long, but I want you to understand it. So, what about the first opinion? The first opinion, ya akhwa, does not stand based on the evidence and based on the practice. Based on the evidence, the one who said that your salat is incomplete and you have no salah unless you recite al-Fatiha, he is the same one who told us what? When it is audible, you listen. You listen. Second, now, tell them when I'm going to read? How it is possible for the follower to read? Is it possible? First, they came with the bid'ah. They invented the bid'ah. Said, well, the imam has to stop after saying Ameen and give enough time for the follower what? To recite it, which is unpracticed nowadays. The one who stops basically is not enough even to what? Go to Al-Haram and see it. It's not enough even to read what? 3 verses. Okay? Second, this second, some they said, well, you recite after him immediately. What does that mean? You say what? When he say Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, you say what? Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. When he says Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim, you say what? Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim. Where is the evidence? No evidence. Why they say, you think they said that? Because they are faced with another what? Trouble. Because other than Al-Fatiha, other than Al-Fatiha is what? Huh? Obligatory or optional?
Optional.
يعني the imam, maybe you read behind me sometime. After Al-Fatiha, I went where?
Ruku.
To the ruku'. If the imam chooses to go to the ruku', then what? What are you going to do? There is no way. However, these are the opinions. And if you want the toilet 2 cents, then the sunnah is to listen, inshallah, Rabbil Alameen. Done? Clear? Clear? طيب. Yes, Habib.
Sheikh, we listen to you in either case. So what should we do?
Listen to me what? Yeah. You hear me?
Yeah.
We do as the Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used sometimes to let them hear it. They used to hear it very clearly. You recite, because it is quiet. As we said, the quiet salah, not loud salah. In the quiet salah, you are going to hear it sometimes. So you recite. Only when you do not recite, when Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim. But if I'm saying, Bismillah Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim, Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, you recite too. You said, sometimes I'm confused. You have to train yourself. Because khayrul hadi hadiyu Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Done?